Your name is Janet McKenzie.
Aye, that's my name.
You were the companion housekeeper to Emily Jane French.
Oh, I was a housekeeper? I have no opinion of companions. Poor feckless bodies. Afraid to a bit of honest domestic work.
Quite so, quite so. I meant only that you were held in esteem and affection by Miss French, and you were on friendly terms together. Not quite the relationship of mistress and servant.
20 years I've been with her and looked after her. She knew me and she trusted me, and many's the time I've prevented her from doing a foolish action.
Miss McKenzie, I'm going to advise you to direct your remarks to the jury.
Miss McKenzie, what sort of person was Miss French?
She was a warm-hearted booty. Too warm-hearted at times, I'm thinking. A wee bit impulsive, too. There were times when she had no sense at all. She was easily flattered, you see.
When did you first see the prisoner, Leonard Bowles?
He came to the house of mine at the end of August.
How often did he come to the house?
To begin with, once a week, but later it was oftener. 2 and even 3 times he'd come. He'd sit there flattering her, telling her how young she looked, and notice the new clothes that she was wearing.
Quite, quite. Now, Miss McKenzie, will you tell the jury in your own words what happened on the night of October the 14th?
It was a Friday, and when I out, I was going around to see some friends of mine in Glenesto, not above 3 minutes' walk. I left the house at 7:30. I promised to tell my friend the pattern of a knitted cardigan that she admired, but when I got there, I found I'd forgotten it. So after supper, I said I'd slip back and get it, as it was a fine night and no distance. I got back to the house at 9:25. I let myself in with McKee, and I went upstairs to my room. As I passed the sitting room door, I heard the prisoner in there talking to Miss French.
You're sure it was the